Hello students, today we are going to learn about the next topic in the chapter 2, that is the igneous petrology, mainly the mode of formation. Before going into the subject, we should first understand what you mean by petrology. Petrology is nothing but the branch of geology which mainly deals with the study of the rock. Coming very detailedly, it is a branch of geology which mainly study the rock, where petro means rock. Logy means study. So nothing but petrology is the study of the rock. Now let us see what is the classification of the rocks and how rocks are classified. Rocks are mainly classified into three types. What are those three types? The first type is igneous rock. The second one is sedimentary rock. And the third one is metamorphic rock. Coming to the igneous rock, we know that it is the most abundant rock among all the following rocks. It is also known as a primary rock. The main source of the igneous rock is magma or lava. Okay, when there is a volcano eruption, so there may be the eruption of magma or lava. Due to this solidification of these rocks, these igneous rocks are formed. Okay. These are the underlying rocks. Coming to the sedimentary rocks, these are the thin venar above mainly the CL or the SEMA. Those are the limitations in the oceanic and also the continental crusts. These rocks are also known as sedimentary rocks. Okay, these are known as sedimentary or secondary rocks. Coming to the third variety, that is metamorphic rocks. So, these are very much similar in proportion to the igneous or sedimentary rocks. These are very much similar to the igneous rocks. Only there is a change of forms of the igneous sedimentary rocks. This change is mainly due to the changes in the temperature, changes in the pressure, and the chemical fluids which are acting on the different parent rocks. Coming to the importance of petrology in civil engineering, let us see how and what is the importance of petrology or this branch. Generally, it provides a vast opportunity to know the physical properties of the different rocks like texture, structure, and the composition of the mineral and also chemical composition. If you take a rock, physically what are the different type of properties are there, this branch is going to deal with that, like texture, structure, mineral and chemical composition, color, etc. It also helps in knowing what is the strength and what is the durability and what is the appearance and how is it workable in different conditions. So this branch is very vital. These properties will help a civil engineer mainly to know the properties of the rock at different conditions, where they are suitable for the different purposes or not, like are they ideal for the different projects or how ideal or best suited for all the purposes. For example, if we take the granite, what we know, it is a hard material or the hard rock and it is very competent and it is durable. Hence, this granite is used in the foundations. Coming to the limestone, this is very soft comparatively and hence it is suitable for flooring. How we come to conclusion? Because we have to know the properties before coming to the conclusion. Coming to the marble, which is soft and attractive, hence it is used for flooring or sculpturing processes, etc. Coming to the sandstone, it mainly used in sculpturing all the walls, etc. Okay. Coming to the volcano, what do you mean by a volcano? It is nothing but a gap you know, this gap, jet-like structure will be there in the Earth's crust, where this molten rocks and other materials will try to escape outside the surface of the Earth. This is the surface of the Earth, okay? They want to escape from the interior to the exterior. So, what are igneous rocks? The rocks which are formed through this volcanic action, or the rocks which are derived from this molten mass, magma or lava, as already discussed. Okay. So, what is the source of igneous rock? The main source is magma. Molten mass comprising very abundant elements like silicon, aluminium, ferrous, calcium, magnesium, potassium, hydrogen and oxygen. These are the various abundant elements which are present in the molten mass. Also, we have to understand that SiO2 silicon dioxide is the most abundant among all the above said elements. So, mainly the temperature of the magma is around 1040 degrees Celsius to 1200 degrees Celsius. What are the main influencing factors for magma flow and how the igneous rocks are formed? Generally, what happens is these sedimentary rocks, which are overlying as overburden rocks, will play a very important role mainly in the formation of the igneous bodies like diixels, laccoliths, bismuths, phacolites, lopolith, volcanoic necks, batholiths and clonoliths. These are all the technical terms which are used for the igneous bodies which are present. So, this bedding mainly in the sedimentary rocks will help to facilitate the magma, or it will help to push the magma to come outside or to extrude or to inject through the weak planes. There will be some weak planes in the rock. So, these material will try to escape from that weak planes. What are the kinds of igneous rocks? These are the various igneous rocks which are present. This is mainly understood by the Bowen's reaction series. See, there is a continuous series as also discontinuous series. Squares. Here some alkali feldspar is there, biotite, hornblende, pyroxene, olivine. These are all the materials which are present. See, it comes from basalts and gabbrones to andesites and diorites. Rhyolites and granites are formed in the decreasing temperature. From here, the temperature will goes on decreasing. While the temperature is decreasing, there will be the increasing of the SiO2 of the liquids. So, these are the formation of the different igneous rock. Coming to the fluidity of magma. What do you mean by fluidity of magma? It is nothing but the viscosity. What is the viscosity of magma? It mainly depends upon the percentage of silica in the magma. So, it is known as silica rich or silica poor. What do you mean by silica rich? Silica rich is known as acidic magma and the silica poor is basic magma. So, what is the texture or what type of silica rich is there? It will be very viscous in nature and it cannot spread easily. Hence, it piles up at only one place. Okay, it cannot spread. Spreading is not possible. Coming to the silica pore. So, it is less viscous and it will be easily movable from one place to another and occupies a larger area. However, this viscosity of magma generally influences by the temperature also. We have to understand that. Okay. Temperature also. So, coming to temperature, when the temperature is less, it is more viscous. Similarly, when the temperature is high, it is said to be less viscous in nature. Hence, the fluidity of magma is influenced by percentage of silica and also temperature. According to percentage of silica, it is divided into two types, silica rich and silica poor. Coming to temperature, low temperatures are more viscous and more temperatures or high temperatures are less viscous in nature. Thank you.